Okay, everyone, I think we can start the next session, the Meet CEU students session. It's a Q&A session. We have students from almost all the departments represented today. In the first couple of seconds, I would like to give the floor to the panelists to present themselves, the department, and of course, if they are part of any association or organization here on campus or externally. You already know me. I'm Alexandra from the recruitment office. I'm also an alum from this university, and this is my colleague Logan. He's also an alum from environmental sciences department. Currently. Working for the environmental and sustainability office, and today we are going to moderate together this panel. So I hope you will enjoy it. So I will leave the floor for the panelists. Please present yourself in a couple of seconds.
Hello, I'm Ivan from Belgrade, Serbia. I'm a second year PhD in medieval studies here at CEU, and I've done also an MA, so it's my third year here.
Hi, my name is Martin Freundlieb. I'm from Germany, and I'm currently a third-year PhD in the Cognitive Science Department.
Hi, everyone. I'm Nadira. I'm from Uzbekistan. I'm in one-year program in Environmental Sciences and Policy.
Hi, everyone. My name is Melika. I'm from Kazakhstan. I'm studying in a second-year MA Economics program.
Hi, my name is Imogen. I'm a first-year PhD in the History Department, and I'm from New Zealand.
Hi, I'm Alexandra. I'm from Hungary. I'm a first-year PhD student at the History Department as well. And I'm also involved with our student and alumni-run newspaper, the CEU Weekly.
Hi, I'm Khurram. I'm from Pakistan, and I'm in Department of Public Policy.
Hello, my name is Victor. I'm from Hungary. I'm in the Legal Department, more precisely in the Comparative Constitutional Law Program.
Hi, I'm Tuba. I'm from Turkey. I'm a third year PhD student in math department.
Hi, my name is Ezgi. I'm from Turkey. I'm in the sociology and social anthropology program doing my PhD.
Hi, I'm Bernadette. I'm originally from the gender studies, and I'm from Canada. I'm also an alumni. I currently take part in a lot of kind of alumni events. And known as the alumni chapter leader in the city. And if you have any questions also, I work for IOM, or the International Organization for Migration.
Hello, everyone. I'm Joseph. I'm from Nigeria. I'm in the philosophy department in one-year MA program. I do sports, so I'm the soccer club. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Zsófi. I'm from Hungary, and I'm from the Political Science Department 2 years, and this is my second year.
Hello, everyone. My name is Rebecca Joyner, and I'm from Washington, D.C. I just graduated the full-time MBA program at CU Business School, and I've been living here for a year and 8 months in Hungary. My background is banking and finance.
Hello, my name is Bashir Ahmed from Pakistan, and it's my second year at the School of Public Policy. And I'm usually engaged with the recruitment office.
Okay, thank you very much, panelists, for your short introduction, and thank you, Alex, for your initial introduction. I just want to welcome you all again to our community here at CEU, and I think it's a really important thing that you're doing today, because you're at a point in your life where you have a really important decision to make. You're trying to figure out what direction you're heading in, and what you're going to be up to, and how you're going to advance yourself in the next 2 years or a few years, or to make this choice which will impact the rest of your life. So I really encourage all of you to take full advantage of this day to really find out, you know, what life would be like for you here in your individual department, and even here within the CEU community, and here within your either current home or new home of Budapest. So really take this to your full advantage, and don't feel afraid to ask questions, whether it's from your panelists here today, or from representatives of the department, or even anyone else that you pass by in the university today. The point of today's session is to basically, you know, for you to have the opportunity to learn about this institution directly from the citizens of the institution, which are current and former students. So this is supposed to be, you know, their exclamations of their experiences here as a student currently and in the past. So this should be real, you know, the straightforward opinions of people who kind of make this university what it is, which is the student body. So we picked a few general topic areas which we're going to encourage the panelists to speak more about and elaborate about. But certainly, if we don't touch on something in these four general topic areas, there will be time at the end of the session for you to ask any questions about anything you're curious about. And even beyond this session here today, you'll have time the rest of your day to ask whatever you're concerned about from anyone. And after you leave here today, don't feel like it's your last chance to learn about CEU. Please feel free to contact any of us or anyone you meet here today for more information, because we're here to help you. So I will start by introducing our first topic area, which is we would like our panelists to talk a bit about what makes this institution unique. So we're here in this wonderful city. You may have heard how diverse our student body is, but I would pose the question to the panelists: from your experiences, what has made your learning experience here at CEU unique and fulfilling?
One of the things before coming to CEU, I worked in different places, in different countries. And I was more like looking for something where I can implement my learning in practice, more focusing on the human security and international development. During my fellowship at Azerbaijan, I came to know about the Central European University, and I said, well, I think this is the place that I was looking for a long time. And I applied, and I got enrolled, and I joined the School of Public Policy last year. The thing that I have learned, and I really enjoy, is that it is the place where the where the theory comes into practice. What you learn, they provide you opportunity, they provide you a chance to implement it in your practical life. This is the thing that make my experience valuable and more like polish my skills and my attitude and my behavior toward the practical world.
Thank you, Bashir. Anyone? Yes, Rafi?
Well, in the political science department, what I would think is very unique, especially if you are Hungarian and you come from an educational background where you weren't really encouraged to speak that much, where you were mainly used to listening to the teacher and not really engaging in the lectures or in the seminars. What makes CEU really unique for me is that here interaction is very much encouraged. You're very much welcome to talk and share your own experience and own thoughts, and I think that's very, very important. And I also think it's something that we have to learn, and it's very useful to know that teachers or professors don't really see themselves here as the number one authority who always knows the right answer and is right about everything. They are so open to your comments and to students' debates and all that and thoughts and I think that's very important, and discussion is always encouraged. And yeah.
Thank you, Jofi. Guram?
For me, what makes CEU unique is the diverse student body. As I'm in public policy, so when we are looking to a problem, in our class, we look at it from different perspective. There are 29 nationalities in my class. So like 2 days back, we were discussing about traffic issues. So we were looking at it from like London's perspective, from Bangladesh perspective, from Pakistan perspective. So this helps you to think out of the box. And this is something really amazing for me, and I think it is like developing my personality.
Yes, Rebecca?
I would just say, coming from the US, the big draw to CEU is the fact that the school is accredited in the US and Europe, so that really opens up the opportunities for you in terms of traveling and getting work, whether you want to go to the US or stay here anywhere in Europe. That meant incredibly a lot to me, because I know that probably eventually I will go back home and work there, and it's not going to be any kind of question to the credibility of my degree since the university is accredited in the States. Also, just coming from the States as well, we have a large, diverse population, but I would have never gotten the interaction on the international level at the US that I got here, even though the States is so big and so diverse. From our business school, we had people representing every single continent except Australia. So and the program, the program itself, the business school full-time one-year program is 60 credit hours jammed into 11 months. So I was in school 9 to 5 Monday through Friday, in the evening sometimes, and when I wasn't in school, I was working on projects with my teams and studying for exams. Basically, that program pretty much is a trial by fire if you want to know what the kind of work ethic it takes to run your own business. Basically, sometimes I'd have to work on projects that were due in 2 days that I had to meet with my team, break up the project, divide it into who was assigned what, and then we'd meet back in a couple days, collaborate together, put it all together, and be presenting on it in the next day. So, and we did that like 50 times throughout the program. So if you want to really get an intense program where you have to just have everything thrown at you and have to respond to it and speak on it confidently with a short period of time, it was excellent for that.
Thank you, Rebecca. Is there anyone else who would like to add something? If not, I will go to the other topic. Okay, so the next topic, it relates to the student body at CEU and student engagement and opportunities on campus. What can you tell me more, what can you tell me about the initiatives that are taken here at CEU? Groups, available groups, clubs, associations, the centers, maybe you can add something on that?
So as I already mentioned, I am, for instance, involved with our student newspaper, but there are many other student clubs here. We have a very vivid and very diverse student life outside of the courses. Of course, it changes from year to year because it depends on you and the new students, in what they are interested, and in this 21st century, it's very easy to find people who are interested in the same thing as you are. I think now we have also a photography club. There is also typically a hiking club. For instance, this year I think also there is a Korean culture club because there were people who were interested in it. As I see this, for me it's sometimes a bit this productive procrastination, and it's good to get away from your studies, but also it's very good to meet people outside of your department and to widen your horizon.
Thank you, Alexandra.
Yeah. Okay, I'll just jump on that. I think all of us are probably familiar with the school's university's email system, and as you will probably become students, you'll become familiar with it too, and you'll notice that you receive upwards of 20-something emails a day. And all of these are different events going on around the school, different departments, different areas, different things go happening around Budapest, whatever. You'll get this weekly email saying what's on at CEU, and you'll become quickly overwhelmed by a choice of what you want to do. And you probably have no time to see half of the things that you want to, but some of them you will get to see. This week alone, I went to at least 3 different lectures at 3 different departments, visiting scholars, visiting professors, visiting academics, people working within NGOs, whatever. You're going to have the opportunities to see and hear from a number of different people, and this will be happening all the time, endlessly, and probably you'll find yourself disappointed that you won't be able to see everything. And I'm being honest. That's very true.
Just to stress again on that, one thing that makes you really peculiar is in postgraduate studies, one thing that is typical sometimes is that it can be the academic demands can be so absorbing that the individual wouldn't have time for anything but his studies, you know. And a friend of mine who is very close to me, we talk, compare, he's doing his postgraduate studies in one institution in Europe. We talk a lot, and he tells me that he does nothing but study and study and study, and he's so bored with his studies. And in CEU, I'm sure you're going to study and study and study. But for boredom, you won't use the word "I'm bored" because you'd rather be wowed with the events and activities that take place in CEU here, co-curricular events and activities, and some of them have been mentioned. And one thing that is interesting for me that I've discovered within this period is that the college has a way of supporting students with their initiatives. So it's not just that events are happening there and you are watching. You are actually involved in it. And you can bring up any initiative and you'll find strong support for it. And CEU does something during the opening of academic year. There is a survey of students' interests and initiatives. So anything particularly you have interest in within the co-curricular activities, they are sought for, and you present them, and you'll be very much supported. So in CEU, even though we study and study, but also we are not bored, we have wowing moments here that make it very interesting.
Thank you, Jeff.
Just let me share with you how I met CEU. There was a round table about the Fourth Amendment of the Hungarian Constitution. And I thought that, okay, let's attend this round table. It seems to be interesting. And when I arrived, I was so surprised that at least 60 people from CEU attended this round table, and they actually knew about this Fourth Amendment. It was just so surprising how they even know about it. But they knew about it. And so that was one of the reasons I came here, because I saw that it's such an inspiring place, and people get involved in many, many things. So it's not just like people coming here to study solely on the topic of their interest, but also from many, many other fields. And this is only possible because the student board is very active, and because of every office and the student collectivity is very active at CEU.
Thank you, Victor. Is there anyone? Okay.
I just wanted to say that there is also a way to financially support your initiatives and passions. Student Union has a modest but still a budget, and if you want to open a club or initiative, you can like draft your budget, propose to the Student Union. For example, today we have our first general meeting. I'm going to attend that as a regular member of Student Union after this panel. We'll review the draft budget and we'll see like which clubs and initiatives we're going to support and in which way as well.
Okay, thank you very much. So we heard a lot about the opportunities you'll have to enrich your mind and have fun experiences in your free time. But you also heard a bit about that free time is very precious because you will be challenged when you're here. Especially whether it's in a one-year program or two-year program, you're going to be asked to accomplish quite a bit in a very short time. But the good thing is that you're certainly not on your own. A lot of it is up to you and it's your own responsibility, but there are certain helpful institutions and offices here and structures, a structural system at the university to support students while they're studying here. So I would like to ask the panelists to speak a bit more about the very helpful available resources that you utilized during your time studying here. Who are the people you're turning to for help? What facilities are you using to help collect information for your assignments? And how are you using the offices and people at the university to your advantage to help you along the way?
Actually, when I was applying here, I really felt a lot of support from CEU recruitment office. So this support begins with your application, and then it continues during your enrollment, during your studies here. And I'm sure that after graduation, CEU also supports its students. Actually, we have a lot of resources and facilities here at CEU. Well, first of all, it's library, of course. It's the most important because you can find a lot of books for your electronic resources like journals, which otherwise you had to pay for. Here you can have free access to them. Also, there is a career center, which is really useful. It organizes career events, invites different companies to do their presentations, to speak about their opportunities and vacancies. I think it's really important that Career Center helps you with your CV and motivation. I know that everyone thinks that their CV and motivation letter are quite fine. I also thought like that. But from my own experience, I can tell you that after I went to Career Center and asked for a consultation from a professional, my CV and the motivation letters improved a lot. Because you cannot even compare the previous one with the new one. So it's really helpful.
I'd just like to add to the library that in case the book or journal you don't you need is not available in the library, there is interlibrary loan. So you can order it, and in a couple of weeks you receive the book. To this, I would add also two centers available, Center for Academic Writing, which is particularly important for non-English speakers, native English speaker, and many of us are, and that really helps. And finally, Center for Teaching and Learning, which is perhaps more for advanced students, that is if you go into PhD. They have very good programs for students who want to develop as teachers. So that is very good, and they offer a certificate. So that's something that not many universities, especially in Europe, have.
What I appreciate here are the computer labs. And we spent so much time in there, actually. And my friend jokes that he's going to get his chair named after him because he spent so much time in there. And also, second point is university courses, assignments are online. We have a Moodle site. I heard it's like freshly designed, redesigned. Very convenient, so like it's a platform where we students and professors departments interact. They post like handouts and recommended readings. We download them. They grade our assignments online as well. Like we check it regularly, and exams, sample questions and everything. So that's another like online tool facility that I appreciate in CEU.
I'd just like to add that since I'm a part of the alumni and a chapter leader in the city, I would like to point out also that there are chapter leaders throughout the world who take into account alumni and who come here and who get them ready as well to come here. And also once you graduate, your experience isn't over. So basically, you can still use the library, which I do because I live here. And you can also use the Career Center. They help you with finding jobs, or if you need to write your resume or your CVs or something, they help you with that as well. And there's also a lot of programs and events that take place that you can join even after you've graduated, and not just in this city. So these are, we become a large group or a large family even in other countries, and they try to help you to settle in or to find positions that are right for you.
I just would like to add two things. The first is that CEU is very generous, believe me. It offers a lot of grants for students. For example, I have the opportunity to travel to Heidelberg and to Paris because CEU granted me this opportunity because I need this travel for my research, and it was such a wonderful opportunity. And the other thing is that professors are also very helpful. They do care what you write about. They do care what you think. So you can write them and you can get a response in like at maximum 2 days, and they help you with everything, really. So they are very nice.
Okay, one more thing. CEU doesn't only care about our academic progress and intellectual progress, it also cares about our body and our stomach as well. So here you see in the on campus we have a very good restaurant here and a cafeteria. And in the host, I stay in the dorm, we have a very beautiful cafeteria too in the dorm. So you find yourself that you're so busy with work, you don't have time to get into the kitchen to cook. You can have your meal in school, you can have your meal in dorm, and that is very special. And it's an important area that also stands out for CEU.
Okay, we discussed about student life on campus, opportunities here, and of course what makes this environment so unique. But let's not forget that we are placed in Budapest. So CEU is located in the beautiful city of Budapest. What can you tell me about the external events, or how this enriches your experience as a student at CEU? Bashir?
Well, yeah, I consider it now my second home. Well, it's a very beautiful city, a very multicultural. Every day you meet with the people from all over the world. Besides like studies and having readings, assignments, and all these things, you always have the chance and opportunity whenever you get bored, just go out and enjoy your life. you always find something that makes the city tremendous and different from the other part of the Europe. There's Budapest.
I really love the city. It's filled with bars and hold on.
I didn't want to say something.
It's thriving and exciting with a vibrant social life. That's what I'll say. There's plenty of things to do. And from many economies, if you're coming to Budapest, it's relatively cheap to spend your money. Your money goes a long way. I just feel like the city is full of life and so beautiful with the huge Danube running through it. It has, I believe, 7 or 8 different bridges. At night, it's just breathtaking. I mean, I learned later they call it the Paris of the East, and I absolutely agree with that. A statement is beautiful at night, all lit up with all of the bridges. And it, like I said, it's the social scene is very exciting. You'll definitely have a way to release your stress when you're tired of studying and need a break. Outside of that, there's plenty of fitness and health activities as far as gyms and things like that. There's so many things that I didn't do until I came to Budapest. Personally, I learned how to swim, ski, yoga. I mean, there's just so much going on in the city, and it's, like I said, so relatively cheap to other economies to spend your money here. It's just you'll feel like you're running out of time and you'll want to stay here longer than your studies just because it's so exciting. And what I've learned from native Hungarians also is that basically the city is becoming more international as far as there are certain streets you can go on and see plenty of English language signs. And a lot of the businesses, the language of the business is English. There are tons of multinational corporations here where they do business in English. So the language barrier is becoming less of a problem, too, as far as English becoming a stable platform to be used. And when you're going out to restaurants and cafes, you know, you have less and less problem. If you speak a different native tongue, having English as a common base to use. So it's pretty becoming a lot more easy just to get around the city as well for foreigners. And there's a huge expat community here. A lot of people just coming in and out of Budapest because of its central location in Europe, you know. A lot of people coming here for work and studies. So I just think there's so many different exciting people to meet and so much to do. The city is really alive. I love living here.
So I might add, I mean, I'm from Budapest, so this might sound as talking home, but also add maybe that there is also like lots of cultural programs, and what is, I think, very important, that they are affordable. And there are also lots of student discounts, and we are also receiving lots of emails from the student life office who are always updating us. Also maybe like English-speaking theater events and similar activities. And also, like the central position of Budapest, it's also very easy to go to Vienna from here for a Christmas fair, or to go to Prague or to Belgrade, and you can do this together with your CEU friend.
I'd like to add also that it's a very safe city, and that it's bicycle friendly because people really pay attention in traffic. I mean, drivers, of course. And now you have the city transportation introduced, the city bikes. So it's very nice way to travel around Budapest. It's not too big, so in half an hour on a bike, you're basically everywhere. So
I also want to quickly mention, besides all the fun and beautiful things that the city offers, it's also a great place to put your intelligence and your time and what you're learning in the classroom to work. So I personally found it very fulfilling to try to become involved and integrated within society while I was here. So I was studying environmental science issues, and I wanted to, you know, take all of these passionate discussions and what I was going back and forth with my classmates and find people who are in the streets working on these issues and learn more about what's happening regionally. And for me, it was very helpful because I ended up finding a group of people and a topic that I was interested in, which I eventually ended up covering more in my thesis research, which eventually led me into some of the most fulfilling parts of my life now. I'm very much involved in the development of local food systems and sustainable food systems here in Budapest. And I was able to find out about these things by stepping outside of this very comfortable CEU bubble and getting myself involved with the people actually living here in the city. So this has relevance for Hungarians who are living here and know the local context, but also for people who come here from other places as well. I found the people living in the city to be very open and very welcoming, even more so than other places where I lived, and they're looking for help and looking for support. So all of these tools you're using to develop yourself inside of this building, put them to practice while you're here and help it enhance your whole experience as a student, and also think of yourself as a community member and a citizen as well. So the next point that we want to get to quickly, and probably the most important point for all of you, because that's probably why you're enrolling here in a secondary institution, in a master's degree institution, is because you're thinking about where it's going to take you in the long run. You all have your ambitions and your sights set on goals of the future and good opportunities and good employment opportunities. So the next question I would pose to the panel is, how did your time here as a student prepare you for the next steps you're taking in your life? And also, once you started approaching the end of your time as a student, how were you assisted in perhaps helping find employment opportunities afterwards?
Well, I think CEU really helps you to prepare yourself for career. First of all, that's because of the time management skills that you get here. Because you have a lot of assignments and really limited time. You learn how to organize yourself and your friends, how to work intensively and effectively. That's why I think it's a very important skill. The other thing is that most of the assignments are completed in teams. So you always work in teams, which is a really good experience for you to have. Career Center, of course, helps you with finding a job opportunity. Like there are a lot of emails coming from Career Center about opportunities, and there is an annual career fair at CEU, which I think will be in February. And there, they invite many companies like Google, Morgan Stanley, very advanced companies that come and talk about their vacancies, which is really good.
I'll just say a little bit about if anybody's interested in continuing on more in the university sphere. I was told when I was thinking about applying for a PhD that it's the most important decision I'll ever make, even more so than getting married, because you can always get divorced, but you can't undo where you do your PhD. So I really thought hard about it, and the reason that I decided I was very happy to stay at CEU is there are many reasons, but the first of which is that, first of all, you have the opportunity to do something like a PhD here comfortably. You have support from the university. You're financially stable, and this is something that's becoming increasingly rare, especially in the fields that in which I study. The second thing is, like, we have you have to make the most of it as an individual, but you have the opportunities, if you're so inclined, to basically make use of an extraordinary alumni network, which was mentioned. You have the opportunity to attend conferences. You have the opportunity to go to different universities. We have the opportunities to do sandwich semesters abroad. We have colleagues at extraordinary universities over in America, in the UK, wherever. So you can make the most of a lot of things here. The other thing I'd just say also very quickly is, when it comes to thinking about the job market, increasingly I think it's important to make the most of things like the teaching center, but also languages. This wasn't really mentioned yet, but CEU gives you the opportunity to develop and improve upon your language skills, which is something that can set you apart, I think, especially in the European context. I'm from a place where languages are not so heavily stressed, but I think it's something that you can really develop here at CEU, and we have plenty of opportunities for doing this.
Besides all the other opportunities, CEU also introduced the internship opportunities to the students. During your internship, like, you get the chance to get to the organizations to work on the issues that you're really interested in, and you really do care about these issues. It provides you a big networking opportunity to network with the people who are working in the same field and try to find out opportunities to collaborate with these people and find employment opportunities after your graduation. Another thing specifically about the School of Public Policy I would like to mention here is the passion projects. It's a project like when you enroll in the school, you have to work with the client organizations. These organizations are not local organizations, they're international organizations. and you have to work with them for more than a year to develop projects, to come with the policy recommendation, to identify the problems, come with the solution, and implement this policy recommendation to resolve these issues that exist around the world. So it's not just about learning and just about studying, but it's also about networking and about finding opportunities to collaborate with these people.
So I graduated CEU in 2007, and I've been coming back over and over again to the Career Center, for example. And the last job that I, that job currently I have, I actually found on the CEU website for alumni, and where I applied. But I've been, it's really, when I first graduated, CEU has kind of a reputation for excellence, a reputation that you're, if you're already here, you already went through kind of a hard process to get in, so you already have a recommendation just by being here, just by having your diploma from CEU. And being a Canadian, but I'm also Hungarian, so I spoke the language, I applied for jobs here, and that really helped to show that I, what I could do and how I studied, because as was mentioned before, a lot of the European schooling or Eastern European schooling is that you sit in the classroom and you write your exams. And here you really get involved, you have to do presentations, you have to participate, you have to, you're encouraged to have your own opinion, and this already is known when you apply at a job, so you're already seen in this type of light. So I think that coming back over and over again, and even in your own countries, if you once you graduate, they really help you there as well to get involved with the people who are alumni, who might own businesses, that you can also apply for jobs. And so as being an alumni, as having companies in your own country, they already know what you've been through and what you've done. And so this also helps a lot. So it does become a kind of community and really helpful in your here and throughout the world as well. And as you said, in the States as well, it's accredited and you can use it and people know it. So.
Okay, so just very quickly, because I think we're also running out of time, but for those who are interested to not only continue to a PhD level, but also beyond, so I'm in my third year now, PhD, and whereas I've heard from many friends that did a PhD in different fields that they found themselves eventually just being spit out of their program with not really having anything in mind how they could continue, I was quite puzzled that already in the beginning of my second year, my supervisors asked me, okay, so what's your long-term perspective? Where do you want to go? What are your ambitions? So already quite early, we started figuring out a kind of longer perspective, which is now very helpful for me because I have the impression that even though I'm very comfortable still in my third year, it doesn't seem like there's something, a black hole afterwards waiting for me, but there's some strategies and some contacts which are already established that will make it easier for me to continue after the PhD.
Yeah, I was going to stress on the support that comes from the departments, like from my department, because just as you are preparing to begin your graduate studies with anxieties and all of that, when you get into the program, towards the end of it, anxieties again come as to how to continue with your life. And different departments, like my department, the philosophy department, just a few weeks after beginning studies, they begin to prompt us about our prospects, career prospects, and not only prompting those who show interest, like to do PhD, they render practical support to us, you know, through preparing our proposals and guiding us on how to prepare our proposals and connecting us with universities and all of that. So that's actually very helpful and promising. Like when you come to CEU, you are not just left to finish your studies. Even as you want to progress with your studies, you're also supported by departments.
Okay, thank you very much. Before we take your questions, since everyone's here in the room, I just want to remind you that you heard a lot of inspiring things from our over 15 inspiring panelists. And of course, we picked these panelists because we know their personalities and know they're quite dynamic students accomplishing a lot and doing well in all their studies. But what I wanted to say to you all is that if you choose to come here, it's up to you to make the most out of it. You have to challenge yourself every day to do a little bit of extra. To instead of, you know, going home after your class and taking a break, to go to that presentation or to go do something in the city. And while it may seem really challenging and intense for the 1 year or 2 years while you're here, you're going to be so much more prepared for the next steps in your life, and it's going to be what puts you above these other candidates when you're looking for a job. You have all these opportunities when you come here at the university. You just have to keep yourself focused and kind of think about it every day. How can I make the most out of this? And all of our panelists here are very good examples of students who took advantage of these opportunities that they had. So now it's the time of our show where we want to hear from you. So anything that we haven't covered in any of our general topic areas, you now have the opportunity to post questions directly to any of our panelists or the panelists in general. So it's up to you to ask whatever you would like to know more about now.
I would encourage the panelists to use the wired mics, and we will use the wireless one for the audience. So any questions? Please, don't be shy.
When you submit your research plan, do you have to stick to that plan, or you can change it or switch it about during, you know, the course?
Are you asking about the MA program or the MA? No, you don't have to stick to your plan, because I personally had a totally different topic when I applied here for my MA. And in the second month, I decided that I didn't want to do that, and I wrote a totally different proposal, so it's totally fine if you do that.
Questions?
I will ask a question just to get the ball rolling. We talked about really, really good things and everyone being happy and wonderful and taking advantage of all these great things about Budapest and CEU. What was the most difficult thing to adjust to, or what was a challenge you faced at the very beginning of your studies, which you can talk a bit about, because adjustment's going to be important for everyone.
I don't know how many of you are Hungarian. Is there anybody who's coming from quite far away? Yeah? Nice one. Okay, so the first thing that, and I say this a lot, the first thing that freaked me out was withdrawing like several thousand from the cash machine and just being like, whoa, and just getting used to small things like this takes a lot of time, and you know, and knowing where to go for lunch, and when you get ripped off completely and then you realize, oh, you know, this takes a lot of time. But what I would really suggest is when you're first going through the whole journey and you're meeting a lot of people is to try and make friends, you know, as quickly as possible, because you're all going through it together, and you will naturally come together and work on, you know, work off each other and everything like that. But just get into it straight away. I mean, just from the very beginning, kind of launch yourself into it and meet people and say, hi, my name is so-and-so. Even if you're feeling shy, everyone is at the beginning. Once you start forming these friendships, they're really going to last you, I think, a really long time. At CEU, it's very intensive, and you create really strong bonds with people. Sometimes it can be really, really hard to say goodbye at the end of the year, I know. Even thinking about it makes me a little sad, actually. Anybody else?
So I just want to add that I was always told that CEU is a very demanding university, and it is. And I said that, okay, that's what I want, that's what I'm looking for. But when I came here, okay, the first shocking thing was that the legal studies started on the 21st of August. So, and the first exam period was in September, so that was quite shocking. But what was shocking as well, that you really have to read a lot from one class to another, because you don't have time to prepare for your exams. You have to learn from one class to another, because otherwise you cannot pass the exams. So you literally have to read sometimes hundreds of pages from one class to another, really. So get prepared that you have to read a lot. It's very useful, and nobody would leave it. So it's very, nobody quit it. So it was quite a shocking feature.
Well,
I'm from economics department. We don't read much papers, many papers. We actually were more into math people. My program also started on 21st of August. The most shocking part was that you just realize that here is a procession, it ended, it's fine. You're just studying normal basic thing, normal studies. But afterwards, it's only 1 month till midterms, and you really have to, you don't have time to adapt. You just start studying, start working, and that's it. And my advice is when you come here, just go first to the library and start studying there, because it has a great atmosphere. There is a great atmosphere there for studying, and if you start from the beginning, you will have a good dynamics, and afterwards you won't have you won't be shocked by the results of the midterm. So.
Any other questions?
Can I ask something? Yeah. That a lot of times, at least in the political science department, for a lot of courses, you'll have to write papers. So it's not so much exams or midterms, but it's that you have to do your own research. So if you're not very familiar with that, that can be a bit of, not a shock, but it's unusual in the beginning. So if you're if you feel that it's a bit difficult for you, don't be afraid to ask for help in the Academic Writing Center or from your professors. They're really helpful.
Want to add that if you have any difficulties, they really help you. So, for example, there are academic writing courses for those students who are not that perfect in English or who have any difficulties with readings or writing in English. So, really, if you are accepted once, that you will probably have everything to graduate from CEU.
Thank you very much. Next question.
My question is mainly for the master students. Do you have time and the energy while studying at the university to also have or keep your job that you had before?
It's very hard. I volunteer. Mainly volunteer at this at an organization, and it's not easy. It's you have to manage your time very well, but it's not impossible. See, if you really, if you're really committed to it and you really want to do it, then you can. So it's absolutely not impossible. I know other people who are doing internships, and we do have a little less time. You know, for example, last year when we had the break and we had to write papers, a friend of mine was almost done with her papers, and I thought, oh my God, how did I waste so much time during the year that I don't even have a word? And then I realized, well, after school, I never just went home. I went to work, to do stuff. So it's not easy, but if you really want to do it, it's definitely not impossible.
Maybe one more thing that I would like to add is commitment, how committed you are. The thing is that when I joined CEU last year in September, I joined the recruitment office right next month. So I was studying and working, and I worked with the recruitment office till June this year. And then I went for my internship and I come back and I'm joined them back. And at the same time, I'm working on a passion project, which is a part of my degree with the British government. So doing three things at one time. It's all about your commitment. If you're committed with things, you can do anything. And if you are not, well, you know the answer.
We were discussing here about the intensive classes and, you know, the workload. But I'm really curious, how do you cope with? Maybe you have some tips for this, some activities that you are engaging with. Can you please tell me or tell to the audience what would be the activities?
I'll just say one thing that I found really useful. I was in the 2-year master's program here at CEU, and I made a few mistakes in the first year, And I ended up taking quite a lot of courses that I was interested in, which is great. But I think I overdid it a little bit. So you have the opportunities here to audit different classes, both within your own department and other departments. And while it's excellent to be enthusiastic and to make the most of this interdisciplinarity that we have at the university, try not to overstretch yourself too much. I would also recommend that you think about taking 4-credit classes and not take so many 2-credit classes, because I think most of us can agree that sometimes at CEU 2 + 2 doesn't equal 4, right? So you take a lot of courses, and sometimes professors, they're excited about their course, so they'll assign you a lot of work, and they forget that you have 5 or 6 other ones. So my message here is to think very carefully about your timetable at the beginning. You have excellent administrative staff who can help you plan your year. And just think a little bit about what it's going to look like. Think also about when you're writing your thesis and at what times you want to have your semester work, and at what times you want to be a little bit more free so you can think about your own research and give yourself the space to do your writing, because the thesis writing period is very, very stressful. And if you've left all your credits up until the last minute, you'll find yourself having a hellish last couple of months, especially if you're in the one-year program, which is something like a bad pregnancy sometimes at the end. It's painful. Yeah, so just think carefully about your timetable. This would be my advice and my tip here.
Thank you.
So my advice on coping with the stress and all the work is to, I mean, you'll be surrounded with people who are facing the same struggles, so try to talk to them and maybe study together and share, and then it becomes a lot easier when you realize that you're not alone in this, and other people are struggling with these things as well. So I find that really helpful, and go to the gym.
No way.
So we have 5 minutes left, so we can take one more.
I just quickly wanted also to add something to this, that I posed the same question to a history alumni who's now at Harvard, and I suppose that he's good with time management, and it was interesting that he told me, stick to your deadlines and make your own deadlines. And it is also connected to this, that also if you see that you're running out of time, ask for help, ask for your colleagues, and they will appreciate it, because the next time they will need help, you will also be there for them.
So we have time for one more question, a final question from the audience. Yes?
Okay. Do you have like a professional help if you really need it, if you feel like too overwhelmed? I know this, I mean, my brother is doing his PhD in the University of Georgia, and it's like five year program, and he's really small, and he sometimes, there, I know there's an opportunity to talk to like professional, not therapists or something, but yeah, a therapist basically. So if there's something like that, and you can talk to someone who's gonna
yes, there are two psychologists, I guess, at CEU, and I have experience with going to one of them, and it's very, very nice, and they're very helpful, both of them. So there's that opportunity as well, yeah.
Yeah, aside going to meet the psychologists, which is very important, the counselors, maybe not psychologists, counselors, you know, they guide you, which is very helpful. CEU has something very special as well, which I discovered, let's say, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, because in CEU, you really, you know, you are into things. So sometimes you discover something for like, okay, this is my 8th week, okay? So I discovered it like 2 weeks ago, and I make good use of it. And this is the quiet meditation place for the students. It's somewhere on the NADO 11 building, where you go there, for nothing but just be quiet and meditate and recollect. It's a place for recollection. It's so special. When I discovered it, anytime I feel so stressed, wherever, I don't need to go to psychology, I just go there quietly, collect myself. And you can't imagine how that can be very helpful to you to deal with pressure and so many things, yes, so, yeah.
Just one last thing that we said all these things, but do not panic. So in the first couple of weeks, you may will find that it's very demanding, the programs here, but do not panic, because people graduate from CEU, so it's absolutely, so just keep calm and study at CEU.
I feel like debate clubs. You can actually join debate club now, even if you're not a student. Oh, okay. Because like it takes place every Wednesday at 7 o'clock here at CEU, so you can join. Because I also joined it, and there are people who are still studying at school and they're attending this debate club, and also they organize trips to, for example, today there is a freshman trip to Vienna to debate, and there are also many other opportunities like across Europe, to Warsaw, to Belgrade, so you can join. I can give you contacts if you want.
Okay, well, we've reached the end of our time here, and we thank you very much for your questions, and we of course thank our panelists for all their input. And I will just end with saying a few words about my own personal experience, is that one of the most fulfilling parts of being here is the opportunity to learn and exchange from the people that you meet while you're here. We mentioned this a bit in the beginning, but since we don't have a real dominant majority of people from a certain place, we have a university full of mini ambassadors from wherever they came from. And one of the best parts of that is that it's a very, very open environment for exchanging. There's no kind of dominant way of being that you have to assimilate to when you get here. So you come here at the beginning of the year and everybody just wants to know about each other and this place and exchange. And it really kind of snowballs into a very good, comfortable learning environment, comfortable social environment. So while you may have certain topics that you'll have to cover in your classroom, you'll learn about everything else that's happening elsewhere in the world from your conversations and nights out socially and kind of simple exchanges and breaks with your classmates. So you have lots of opportunity to learn in the classroom, lots of opportunity to learn from each other, lots of opportunity to learn from this cosmopolitan city that you're in, and it really makes the whole experience worthwhile. So I will end by saying I hope to see you here sometime in the fall. And make sure to take advantage of all of the people that you meet in the rest of your day here. And thank you again for coming to this 2014 open house.
And just as an added point, we have the next session, Meet Your Department session. So it's going to take place in the laptop area, which is the area outside the auditorium. So please, if you're interested in one of the departments, you can meet the staff, the coordinators, and also the faculty and the students, and you can address your specific questions there. Okay? Thank you very much.